Okay, glad to get out of here with a win. It was, you know, looked good at times, looked bad at times, as I think anybody that was here and watched the game could probably figure out. There's some good things, some bad things. We were either rolling on offense or we were inept. I don't know what it was. Second quarter was good and fourth quarter was good. I'd rather it be second and fourth than first and third. And the defense finally started playing in the fourth quarter, I thought. They had a lot of momentum. You know, we had guys going down left and right. It's no excuse. Guys got to go in and play when guys go down. But we did. We had a lot of main players out. You guys know that. You saw them all on the sidelines. And that affects a lot of different things. I'm sitting there scribbling all kinds of names out on special teams. It's a good thing the last 2 weeks we've been able to do that as well, because we're plugging a lot of guys in that could perform at a level to where we could win a Big 12 football game. So proud of the way the guys just hung in there and put it away in the fourth quarter. That's a sign of a good football team. And obviously the bye week, I think, comes at a good time, get a lot of these guys healthy. I anticipate all those guys will be ready to play against TCU. You know, everybody that was out, everybody that has been out, I think will be ready to roll. So I think we'll be a different team here in 2 weeks. Questions?
And you mentioned really good offensively or in depth. Normally you're big at making those halftime adjustments. I want to see how they count. Did you try to change anything, or did you just roll right into the third quarter anymore?
We didn't try anything different. I don't know. We didn't. They had a lot of momentum. They were playing good. We didn't convert on third downs. Didn't play very good on offense. We flipped the field and we started to go with the wind. I don't know if that had anything to do with it. I didn't think the wind was a factor at all. I think it helped in the kicking game a little bit. But offensively, if we can't handle that, we got some issues. I don't think that was it. But if it was, then it'd get addressed. But they played good in the third quarter. Give them credit. But I'm glad that we played good in the fourth quarter. Good enough to win by whatever we won by, 20-22. So that's a good win on the road in the Big 12. We'll take it.
And what can you do about the defense against the rush? And that kid had like 300 yards.
I think when you're missing some really good players, you know, getting 11 back is going to help. Not playing with number 8 the whole time is going to help. Getting 16 back is going to help. Those guys are three guys that can get to the ball and have made a lot of tackles for us. You know, you take those guys out and we're playing three freshmen. It's tough to, it's, you know, and I'm glad we did, and I'm proud of the way 9 went in there and played, the way 1 went in there and played, the way 10's been playing. Those guys have been playing good, but those three guys need to be playing a whole bunch of snaps on special teams right now, not on defense. We got to get our main guys back if we want to not have games like that. It's as simple as that. But we will. We are going to get those guys back. I don't think we're good enough to where we're 2 and 3 deep, to where we can play 2 and 3 deep guys and not and stone people. Well, I don't think we're going to be able to do that. There's a lot of good offenses in the Big 12. Kansas is pretty good on offense. They're going to do this to a lot of different people. I'm not happy about 300 yards of rushing, but you get your starters back, I think it'd probably make a little bit of a difference.
How about this kid?
He's fine. He'll be fine.